what I like that Peter said is this has been no easy journey. You know, I'm not going to lie, whenever we first got the license and the permit, we thought, cool, let's do a radio station, how hard can it be? Jesus, I won't swear because I'm trying to be sophisticated today. This has been really flipping, mother flipping hard. To the point that our leadership, who you're going to meet shortly, there's been times they've come to my house and I give them booze, and I'm like, girl, you just got to give up or else I'm going to shoot myself in the face. This is not worth it. This is some bullshit, okay? It's really, really hard, and there's a lot of stories we could tell you, but I just want you to know that it's a really big deal that we're here. This really was driven home to me. I was at a conference in Atlanta a couple years ago, and I was at the bar drinking, and there was a gentleman next to me just making small talk, and I happened to mention that my friends are working on a low-power FM radio station, and he literally almost fell off his stool and turned to me, you know, booze aside, and looked deep into my eyes and was very serious and said, I might swear, you can censor this, Mansoor. Do you have any fucking idea what a big deal it is that you have this license? Do you have any fucking clue how hard these are to get and what a big deal it is? And I sat there speechless because I didn't know. I thought, cool, I guess everybody gets one of these. It's cool. Let's just rock it, right? But it really dawned on me then that this is no small thing, that what we've achieved and what we've accomplished is a huge deal. And I think Long Beach is so rad and so diverse, so for us to have any kind of way to, you know, plant the seeds and create our own community radio, as Peter was saying, and especially in the face of these really challenging times, I'm really proud of all of us who persevered, and I really want to drive home to all of you, it's a really big fucking deal, okay? So let's, you know, I'm gonna introduce you to our leadership shortly, but I would ask that you, as you go forward and leave here today, spread the message to your friends. We want this message to go far and wide. Talk to people about this. Have them become members, because even to get to this point, I wish I could tell you all those stories, even to get to this point in this lovely space and talk to you today, I think has caused our leadership bleeding ulcers. I mean, Ashley, right? Ashley has multiple bleeding ulcers. So I really want you to know that we don't take this lightly, and I want you to fight with us and fight alongside us so we can, you know, celebrate Long Beach in the way we all want to, okay? So with that, I want to introduce the superheroes who've made this possible. And look, I work at a video game company. I don't use the word superhero very lightly. They really are superheroes. But actually, I'm going to introduce our leadership that's going to talk today, but I also want to give a shout out to those people who've been fighting this good fight for a damn long time, and people who've been with it for day one. So I'm going to just say your name, if you could raise your hand so we could all say thank you. Doug and Judy right here, been fighting a good fight. Really, really, since day one. Moni, sitting right there, she's been fighting a good fight. Alex, I saw Alex here. There's Alex over there. Mansoor, behind the camera, fighting a good fight. These people have been fighting so hard, and it's really been unbelievable because I honestly don't think I could have done it. They've come to my house and I'm said, give up, we don't need this. But they refuse to give up. So with that, let me introduce you to our three rock stars today. Everybody, Doug, Judy, Moni, Alex, have been working hard, but these three, to make this day, everybody's been working really hard, but these three are going to give presentations today to kind of share with you some really big, exciting news. I guess, are you going to come up one by one or at the same time? Okay. So first, all these people, I mean, I wish I could tell you all that's what these people have done. So first we have Jeannie Kyle. Jeannie, raise your hand. Or come on up, Jeannie. I guess she is our secretary and museum treasurer. She has more patience than God, I'm not going to lie. Right, Jeannie? You're amazing. And then I've got Jordan Fitzpatrick, our vice president. Where's Jordan? Jordan, listen to this. This is how rad the universe is. Jordan works at KLOS and had KLOS donate our entire recording suite of equipment to KLBP. So that doesn't even make sense in my small little brain. And then our fearless leader who sends me emails and texts at 2 a.m. because she's up working on KLBP alongside her really demanding job. This woman kicks holy ass. This is our president, Ashley Aguirre. Come on, Ashley. There you go. She's amazing. Thank you, everybody.
Give me 1 second, I gotta get our presentation going again.
Thank you, Andrea. Thank you, Peter Frank, for coming and talking to all of us today. I won't get too into it because I'll get emotional, but it does mean a lot to have you guys here and supporting us. I mean, you've all heard what a crazy project this has been. So I wanted to start off just by introducing you guys to our organization and what we do. Our nonprofit, the reason we actually were granted the permit was because we are a community benefit nonprofit. So we actually provide education, assistance, and so that made us a standout for the FCC. LBCTMC, which is Long Beach Community TV and Media Corporation, we were founded in 2009 to bring public access TV back into Long Beach. So that was the original fight for it. And our mission, our mission is to promote and foster the use of community access media outlets and programming through the support of production, promotion, and dissemination of public media through the City of Long Beach and the Los Angeles Basin. So we're really here to help you guys get on air and get your voices broadcast. So I wanted to go over what our updates and changes are for 2018. We've had to go through some things, and we realized from an organizational level there were a few things that needed to change, including our name, because it is a mouthful. And every time you try to tell someone Long Beach Community Television and Media Corporation, it's really long. So that is still our full legal name, but we've changed it to just be Long Beach Public Media. So we've just filed a DBA to do business as Long Beach Public Media, and also Long Beach Public Radio, which is our official tagline for our radio station, 99.1 KLBP. So this won't affect, again, our legal name, our call letters, or our purpose. So it's a simple change that we do with the FCC. I mean, sorry, not with the FCC, more with the Secretary of State. Other than that, we don't have to change anything. One of the other changes is our bylaws. So in the process of getting everything organized, we actually realized how flawed our actual bylaws were. They used to be about 30 pages. There were things mislabeled, and they were kind of passed through by previous leadership on a rush without really giving them much thought. So we've worked with legal counsel to get them down to 9 pages. So our members have copies of them, and you'll be able to ratify them later. So we want to go over what some of the significant changes are. As far as memberships go, we've added an organizational membership. So we allow memberships to individuals. So if anybody wants to join as an individual, it's $50 a year. You get voting privileges as a member. But the thing we've added is a 90-day waiting period. So that just means that you just can't show up today and pay $50 and vote. And that's to protect, you know, voting. You want people who are engaged with your community and know what's been going on and make informed decisions. The organizational membership, however, are people in the community or other organizations who have a similar mission, you know, someone like the Arts Council. They would get an organizational vote, so they would designate one representative to vote on their behalf. But they would also come in and be a member of our organization. And then for directors, we wanted to change some terms and commitments. So our terms now, you can serve 3 consecutive 3-year terms, which then you will take a 1-year hiatus, which is fine. So you can still continue to be on the board long term. It's just 3 consecutive terms, which each term is 3 years. So you could be a board member for 9 years consecutively. And then you just have to take a 1-year break, and then you can run a year later. The other thing too is we decided to update with no relative spouses or domestic partnerships serving at the same time. Because one of the things you see is we want to avoid conflicts of interest, and that's one of the things that you want to protect your organization from. And then our advisory council. So we're in the middle of forming our advisory council, which is going to consist of professionals in radio and business to kind of help us along the home stretch when we're getting ready to launch. They'll meet quarterly, and they're only required to attend at least 1 meeting per year, but they don't have any voting privileges. They're just kind of there to be our advisors and, you know, our extra team when we need them. And some 2017 highlights. So legal victories. I'm going to let Jeannie talk about that a little bit.
Get on the other side.
So for the last 2 years, we've had to kind of put our whole project on pause while we straightened out some disagreements amongst an ex-board member. And after 2 dismissed lawsuits and some dismissed petitions with the FCC, we now are in the clear and able to move forward. And I just want to mention that we've had like 5 different attorneys offer their services pro bono and give us some minimal services at a hugely discounted rate, and that's why we were able to get through this.
Name names.
Sherry Diamond, who is was on the board of the Arts Council, and David Zelligs, who's here. Jeff LeBeau could not be here today. He's traveling out of the country. And David Barnett was, he's not an attorney, but he should be. He's been in law school, and he helped us so much writing all our briefs and everything.
Jan Goodman.
And Jan Goodman, who is an attorney and on the board of KPFK.
Oh, yeah.
And Peter Frank has given us some advice as well.
And then as Ford as Jordan, you might have heard earlier, helped us secure a pretty significant donation of equipment. So we basically have enough equipment to run 3 studios.
Hello. Yeah, so like Andrea mentioned earlier, I do work for 95.5 KLOS, and they were sympathetic to our cause and gave us a bunch of their old gear. Essentially, we built a new studio last December, so the stuff that was running the studio for the past 27 years was going to the wayside. So we saved it from the dumpster, and we're going to put it to good use again.
The other accomplishment too has been some board development. So we as a board have gone through nonprofit training in the last year, which has been very beneficial, because most people think you can just join a board and everything is good, you just sit there and make decisions, but it's a real commitment. So all of us have really sat with people to kind of recognize what these commitments are, what our obligations are to the organization. And just so you know, all of us are unpaid volunteers. Board of directors don't typically get paid, so there's no money in this for us. But we've done that. We've also instituted a conflict of interest policies as well, so that all of our directors understand, you know, that this isn't a personal benefit project. This is really about making it something that works and lasts. We also launched our first workshop series, and we have a couple people in the audience who worked alongside Jordan to do our first beginners production workshops. That would be Melanie Hiller, Dean Westerfield, Jeff Guarino, and Eric Feigl, who I'm not sure if Eric's here today, but Eric's also helped us run some of those. And our next workshop is
next Sunday,
and that's an editing workshop. So if you want to find out info about getting involved with that, we can talk to you after the meeting and get you all the info you need for that. The next thing is we have our biggest announcement to make to date, and you guys are actually going to get to see this agreement actually signed and done. So we are getting a studio built out basically from the bottom up, and it's through the generous kindness of Ron Hodges. So we're actually joining the Shannons family, so we're going to be part of this complex. So below we'll be built out beneath Shannons, so we're part of this 201 complex. So there's a stairwell that goes down to the bottom. You'll see some offices. That's where we're going to get built out. And this space will allow us to house not one, but 2 studios, an on-air room and a production room. The construction, I believe, is what, 4 to 6 months, Ron? We always got to be safe with construction estimates, right? So this is kind of a general layout of of our studio. There will be an entrance where you go in, and there will be a hallway. We'll have you may not be able to see it on the end, but we'll have a screener booth, an on-air room, a production room, and our engineering room that will house all of our serverware. The great thing is, I'm not sure if I can really tell you what's going next to us yet, but there we will be built alongside another special thing that Ron is working on. And we'll have about a 3-foot pony wall with a glass panel. So at the other space, you'll be able to look into our studio. We won't be part of the space technically,
But if you're hanging out at that space, you get to kind of observe and see what's going on. And we will be occupying that space for 10 years. We're getting a 10-year lease. And Ron has generously donated, taking care of the planning, the building costs for us. We'll still have to do some fundraising for some minor things in the studio, but I want to bring Ron Hodges up here to talk about this a little bit and sign the agreement with him.
When I first met Ashley and talked to some of the gang, their vision was really sounded great to me. So we have this whole building space that I thought this would be a perfect spot. I was putting a speakeasy down there.
Woo!
So I had a different theme and design concept for it, and I thought, no, you know, maybe we could work the radio station right into the speakeasy. So you can sit outside on the patio below the stairwell if you go down and take a look. We can put things out there to sit in, and you can watch people inside the booth, interviews or whatever. And I just think it's going to be great. We plan to do street events out here. Am I holding this the wrong way? There you go. We're planning to do street events out here on the Broadway and Pine quite often, and so they can go out and do live coverage of that, or performances up here, or things like that. I just think all together it's going to be an exciting addition to Shannon's on Pine.
As Ron mentioned, this space that you're in right now, they do a lot of great events here, so we're going to work on getting an actual audio and visual feed going on here, so that if we want to do some live performances, some panel discussions, some live DJ events, we can actually feed them directly into our broadcast. So I'm going to bring Jordan up to talk a little bit about engineering and programming and where we're going with that.
Seriously, I've been waiting for that signature for like 2 weeks now. That is a really big deal.
It is.
You guys believe.
Yeah. Yeah.
This space, centrally located with all that they already do, aligned with what we intend to do, it's just a beautiful opportunity to be a part of it, and we look forward to growing together with your own.